Shalom. I will read to you Tehillim 63, verses 1 through 8. To the glory of the Father of eternity, my Holy Father, who I adore and love, the Holy One of Isra'el. O God, you are my God. I will seek you eagerly. My heart thirsts for you. My body longs for you. In a land parched and exhausted, where no water can be found, I used to contemplate you in the sanctuary, seeing your power and your glory. For your grace is better than life. My lips will worship you, Adonai. Yes, I will bless you, precious Holy One of Israel, all of my life. In your name, I will lift my hands. I am as satisfied as with rich foods. My mouth praises you with joy on my lips. When I remember you on my bed and meditate on you in the night watches. For you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice. My heart clings to you. Your right hand supports me. Oh, how my soul loves and worships the Holy One of Isra'el. The God of Abraham, Yahizik, and Yaakov. Yahweh, the Holy One of Israel. Besides him, there is no other. I praise and worship the Holy One of Israel. My greatest desire in this life is to make the Holy One of Israel . How do I make him smile? Bang his mitzvah. Living in the will that he has for me. Not complaining, but rejoicing in my God. For he alone is holy and righteous and true. Those that love him, he makes righteous, and he calls into glory. Hallelujah. All Adonai wants is for us to be obedient to him, to love him, for he alone is God, he alone is worthy to be praised. He's holy. Glory to God. Praise Adonai. For he's worthy to be praised. And he loves you. And he loves you. No good alone. than God. He gives his only begotten Son. That we may have eternal life. Hallelujah. Adonai cares for you. You must live by Adonai. Be living sacrifices for the Holy One of Israel. Keep his Torah. Hallelujah. Righteous. He's written the Torah on our hearts. Hallelujah. Tehillim 19. The heaven declares the glory of God. The dome of the sky speaks the works of his hands. Every day is utter speech, even night. It reveals knowledge. Without speech, without a word, without their voices being heard, their line goes out through all the earth. And their words to the end of the world. Praise Adonai. It is our reasonable service. Hallelujah. We were created to worship Adonai. Adonai, the ultimate secret master. I love you. He knows the depth of my love for you. I adore you. Adonai is my earth. I live, die, Adonai. And I do Ruach HaKodesh spoke to me last night. And he said, my greatest agony is to cast a soul into hell. Hell wasn't created for human beings. It was created for the demons and their angels, but not for human beings. Human beings were created in the image of God. Adonai wants a relationship with us. He wants his children to come home and to live with him. As Adam and Eve lived with him in the Garden of Eden. That's the kind of relationship he wants with us. He wants us to be faithful to him. To love him. He's calling his children home. And I said to him, the Holy One of Israel, the Ruach HaKodesh, greatest agony. He's casting a soul into hell. It was not created for human beings, but for Satan and his angels. I'm sure. Hallelujah. Come to Yeshua. Hallelujah. Who is a propitiation for our sins. Hallelujah. Adonai doesn't want anyone lost. Is going to say. Because of my love for Adonai, my commitment, I am even more persuaded to tell people about salvation and Yeshua HaMashiach, to pray for my soul. My greatest joy is praising and glorifying Adonai. But he let me know. Pray for lost souls. I do pray for them. Not really as much as I glorify Adonai. But he let me know.
I want my children to go. The hardest thing that a shul will ever have to do is to sin. Apart from me, you work as a iniquity. I know you're not. Screw this agony. That's why he hasn't come back yet. Because he wants to draw more souls into his kingdom. Except Yeshua HaMashiach is your savior. Know that he is the son of ADONAI. ADONAI, Yahweh, in the likeness of sinful flesh. The life is in the blood. Hallelujah. Only blood is an atonement for sin. It's written in Leviticus 17:11. Man can't be saved by the blood of bulls and goats. Only by the redeeming blood of Yah. So Yah came to earth in the likeness of a human being, as we are in the likeness of God. But are we God? We're not God. Yeshua was like us, only physiologically. They had the fullness of the spirit of Ruach HaKodesh, John the flesh. Hallelujah. Like a human being. But not a human being. Hallelujah. Just like we were made in the image of God, but we are not God. Come to ADONAI. Come to ADONAI. It's as great as that. He doesn't want anyone to be lost. He spoke to my spirit and said, I created hell for Satan and his angels. Not for human beings. Come to Yahweh. Give your life to Yahweh. Accept Yeshua HaMashiach as your son. God bless you. I love you. Yahweh, Ashmo, Bab, may forsake you. Yahweh, takes care of you. No good at all. The man who believed on his life was right.